Hello everyone. Today's video will be on capturing a screen or taking screenshots using PowerShell. So I will be discussing a script by using which you can capture your screen or anything. So it's a very simple script and I hope you will enjoy it. So as usual, this capability is built in .NET library, and as I have discussed in my previous videos, which you can go through by clicking the I button, in which if you want to use any of the capabilities of the .NET, then what you have to do is you have to use the assemblies. Okay, so what you have to do, and you have to use these assemblies, and once you use these assemblies, you can use that capabilities in PowerShell, capabilities of the Windows or .NET in PowerShell. So how we do it? We do it, we have a cmd let called add type, okay, and then something is wrong, I think. Okay, this will be like add type. And then I have to use the assembly name system dot windows dot forms. Remember, we have used this assembly before also. So if you want to know in detail about this assembly, then you can refer to my previous video by clicking on the I button. Okay. What is behaving? Yeah. And then again, we will be using another assembly, that will be system. Drawing system dot drawing. Okay, so we will be using these two assemblies here. Now what we have to do is we have to give the details of the resolution of the screen of which we want to capture the image, okay, or we have to give the screen's resolution so that PowerShell will know that I have to capture this much of resolution of the screen or this much of screen only. So how we will do it? We'll do it. Let's give a comment here to capture screen resolution. Okay. And how we can do it? Let's create a variable first. I'm going to create this variable screen, and then I'll be using this assembly. Since I have referred the forms, then I am using forms assembly windows forms, then dot system information. And for those who are having difficulty that why I'm doing, don't worry, you will come to know. This is just a format, you don't have to do anything. Just this is just like calling calling the capabilities or using the capabilities of the .NET. So it's like, let's choose. Okay. And now what we have to do is here, we have to define or we have to give the width of the screen, is how much screen we want to capture, then height of this screen, then left and right, left or top, sorry. So how we will do it? Let's create another variable, and then we will be using this variable, $screen variable, and then width. Similarly, it will be Similarly, we will be using height, and how we will get the information of the height by using the similar approach, height, and then left again dollar screen and left and top. This is just a simple thing. Means if you are using or capturing anything, then you will have an idea that what is this width, height, left, top. You will have understanding. Means we are just giving the configuration of the screen of which we want to capture the snapshot. Okay. Now what we have to do is. Now we have to, now since we have given the screen resolution, now we have to give the configuration of the image type. Okay, the image or the image type. So means what type of image do I want to create? Here I will be creating the bitmap image. Okay, dot bmp image you can say. So how I can do it? This thing is in the library. Okay, so I have called here the assembly drawing. Okay, so if you have called the assembly drawing and if you want to convert that thing into an object, then you have to use this CMDlet called new object, because you have called it, but you have to convert that assembly first into an object, and then you can use it later on. Then you can use that object. Once it gets converted into an object, then it has various properties and methods which we can use for our purpose. So, but before using that, we have to first convert it into an object. And how to convert it into an object? By using this CMDlet called new object. So, what object I will be using? Drawing. Okay. Dot bitmap. Okay, and what I will be doing here? Dollar. I'll be giving the width of the screen image, and then I'll be giving the height of the image. Okay. Now since I have defined that image will be of the type bitmap. Now how I can create that thing? Let me store this object into a variable, and so that I will be using that variable later on in my code. So how? Let me give the name is what. Let me create a variable called bitmap. Okay, this is the variable called bitmap. Now let's create the graphic object. Okay, this is the we have defined that we'll be using. We will be creating the image in bitmap format. Now I have to resolution is defined, once the image type is defined, then I will be now creating the image. Means it will be asking the PowerShell script to take the or capture the image. Okay, so to capture the image, what I have to do? I have to tell PowerShell to do this. This is the object system.drawing.graphics. Okay, and then there is a method called fromImage. Image, and then I have to mention this thing bitmap. Means what? Now you understand. Means I have asked PowerShell to capture the image. Okay, this will do the capturing of the image, and once the image is captured, then what will be the format of the image, whether it will be a JPEG or whether it will be PNG or whether it will be a bitmap. So here I have defined it to be a bitmap image. Okay, now since it has captured the image also. So okay, and let me store this also into a variable. And what variable will be that? Let that variable be graphic. Okay. Now since we have even captured the image. Okay, so the final step will be, once it captures the image, I have to ask the PowerShell to capture the image from the screen. Okay, so these are basically instructions. My first instruction is, first what I have done is, I have included the assemblies, or called the assemblies, these assemblies. Now in the second, what I have done is, I have captured, or I have to give the screen resolution of which I want to capture the image. Here I have used the new object CMDLet to create an object called bitmap, okay. And I have given the width and height of the image. Now what I have now since and the this final step is about means I have to create an image in this format. Now this final step is to capture the image, okay, means to take the snapshot. So how I will be how it will do, we'll be using this variable $.graphic, then copy from screen, and then you have to give certain means configurations, okay. The left image, the left side, the top side, which we mentioned already, and then you have to hide, and then you have to give height and width. Okay, it will be 00, and I'm not sure about these 00s, so let it be. And if I'll find that what these signifies, then I will mention those things in the comment, in the description. Okay, for now, you can see that. We are going good, okay. And let's check bitmap. Okay. Now since we have now we have captured the screen also, then we have to save this file somewhere, okay. So final step will be save the file. So how we will save? We will save the file. $bitmap dot save, okay, and then we have to give the address. So right now I want to save this file at my desktop. I have to save it and save the file at a particular location. Here I will be saving my image on the desktop. So here this is the address of the desktop, and I have to give some name. So I'm giving the name PowerShell capture dot bmp. Okay, sorry. Dot bmp. Now let's see if I run this script, what happens. So let me minimize it, and now let's see. You can see that there's only one image file here, and we don't have any other image files. So let's see why if I run what happens. Okay. Oh, you can see here that we have got image. This image, and this image name is PowerShell capture. You can see that it has captured this image. Okay. And we can see the properties, what type of image it is, and what is the, so that means we can verify that whatever we have created. So you can see that this is a BMP file. The name of this is PowerShell capture. Okay, and I have just created it. Means today is May 18, 2021, and this is I've created it 1 minute ago. So you can see that we have just created another image, we have captured an image, not created. Actually, we have captured an image of my desktop by using PowerShell script. Let's create another image, or let's capture another image. I'll be giving the name something like this, okay, so that we can again verify. Okay, just see on the desktop, you can see now here that again another image has appeared. Okay, so you can see that by doing so, by using this simple PowerShell script, we can capture screen. Okay, and it is a very useful thing if you are creating any application which requires certain troubleshooting, because if you have the image of a particular error, then it's very easy to troubleshoot. Okay, so it's a very useful script which I have used in many of my applications which I create using PowerShell. So it is one of the I think best things I found till date or till now. So it's very important and very simple. So I hope you'll find it very useful. And if you want me to discuss something else regarding this video, then you can mention those things in the comment box. And if you really like my video, then please share and subscribe to my channel. And give a thumbs up if you like the video, and keep encouraging me. Thank you.